friends, welcome to Crisp Class. I am Monica and today we will study algebra. Today we will do sums on variables. Let us solve this sum. Rakhi traveled 4x km distance by walk, 2y km by cycle and 9 km by bus. The total distance covered by Rakhi in an algebraic expression is. So we have to find the total distance which is covered by Rakhi in an algebraic expression. Let us write the steps first. Distance covered by walk. Rakhi traveled 4x kilometer distance by walk. So here we will write 4x kilometers. This distance is which she covered by walk. 2y kilometers by cycle. Distance covered by cycle is 2y kilometers. And 9 kilometers by bus. So distance covered by bus is 9 kilometers. Now we have to find the total distance covered by Rakhi in an algebraic expression. So, the total distance covered by Rakhi is equal to, total will be addition of all these, 4x plus 2y plus 9 kilometers. So, this is the total distance which Rakhi covered. This is the algebraic expression. This is the algebraic expression for this question. The total distance covered by Rakhi. 4x plus 2y plus 9 kilometers. Let's do another question. The algebraic expression for the statement product of x and a subtracted from the product of b and y is. So we have to write the algebraic expression for this statement. Product of x and a. Product of x and a will be written as this ax. Product of b and y. Product of b and y means b multiplied by y. This is by. Now we have to write the algebraic expression. The algebraic expression for the statement product of x and a subtracted from the product of b and y minus ax. So this is the algebraic expression. Product of x and a subtracted from the product of b and y. Now let us see this question. Half of a number added to 10 is 15. Find the number. Here we have to find the number. The number is not given to us. Now see, here we will use the variable to find the number. Let us see how we can use variables to find our answer. Let the number is equal to x. In such questions, what we do is we have to find the number. So we will suppose that the number is x and we will write the equation according to it. Half of a number means half of x. Here we have assumed that the number is x. So half of the number added to 10 is 15. Half of the number added to 10 is 15. This is what is given to us in our question. Now we will solve this further so that we find the value of x. And x will be our number. The value of x will be the answer. So what we have to do is we will take all the numbers one by one to the other side of equals to. So that we can find the value of x. See how? This is half of x. 15 minus 10. Here 10 is in addition. when we take it to the other side of equals to, it will become a subtraction. See, we have to remember, whenever we take shift the number from one side of equals to the other side, the sign changes, its operation changes. If it is an addition in this side, when it is shifted to the other side, it will be in subtraction. If it is in multiplication, it will become division or vice versa. So now what we get? This, it can be written as x by 2 is equal to 5. 15 minus 10, we have got 5. Now see here, 2 is in division with x. So when we shift it to the other side, it will become a multiplication. From here, we are shifting this side. X is equal to 5 multiplied by 2. This 2 has been shifted to the other side of equals to. It has become a multiplication. So what we get? X is equal to 10. So the value of x is 10. That means we have found our number. Number is 10. The number is x. We have supposed it to be x here. Let the number be x. So the number which we have got is 10. Now if we put this 10 in this equation, it will suffice it. Let us solve another question. In the given figure, find the magnitude of angles shown. See, we are given this figure. We have to find the magnitude of these angles. Here the angles are given in the form of variable. One angle is equal to x degree. The other is equal to 3x degree. So let us see how we will find them. See, we see that this is a straight line. These angles, they are formed on the straight line. We know that angle which is formed on a straight line is equal to 180 degree. We know this, a straight angle is equal to 180 degree. That means this angle, this whole angle is equal to 180 degrees. What does that mean? That x plus 3x, the total of both these angles should be 180 degree. Therefore, 3x degree plus x degree is equal to 180 degree. Now 3x plus x becomes 4x is equal to 180. Now x will be 180 divided by 4. See here, 4 is in multiplication with x. So when we take it to the other side of equals to, it will become in division. So what we get? X is equal to 45 degrees. We've got the value of x, one of the angles. Now we have to find the other angle. The other angle is 3x. So this becomes 3 into 45. This is equal to 135. So we have found the magnitude of both the angles. One is 45, the other is 135.